What is up, YouTube and the We Want Funko Army? This is yours truly, the life of the party monster, coming at you guys with yet another video. And you guys already know, you guys are watching We Want Funko, the channel that puts the fun back in Funko. First of all, thank you guys so much for checking out my last video. You guys made it one of my highest view videos, so I really appreciate the support. But anyway, we're back on the grind today. It is officially the Emerald City Comic Con Share Pop release 2020, and I gotta say, guys, the lineup this year is super weak. Like, there were so many better pops out last year that it's kind of a good thing in retrospect, because I don't have to spend so much money, because it's only like four or five I'm actually going for. One being the Freddy Funko headquarters pop that I think releases on the website at like 10 o'clock. But other than that, I'm going for the Zanya, I believe her famous, at Hot Topic. Actually, I'm going to go pick that up right now. Other than that, not too many pops I'm crazy about this year. Like I said, I mean, the Thanos pop looks really cool. The Milhouse one is okay, but I am not driving to another mall just to go to a box lunch to pick up Milhouse. Sorry, Fallout Boy, but it ain't happening. So we're about to go head to Hot Topic real quick. I actually have to go to work in like 20 minutes, so I'm gonna have to rush in there, get my pops, and rush right back out. But after I get off work at like 2 o'clock, I'm gonna go check out GameStop, see what they have still available, and hopefully we can get that green He-Man and that Thanos pop. But I don't know, it could be hit or miss, but I'm gonna try my best, and at the end of the day, I'm gonna show you guys what I picked up. Okay guys, so we're kicking things off at Hot Topic, and here's a secret about Hot Topic and their shared pop Comic-Con releases. They have a ton of them. You don't have to go there early, but there's this one that you're dying to have. But other than that, you can go up there super late and get all the pop that you're trying to acquire, because they have a overwhelming supply of them. So never fret, go there whenever you can. That should be actually your last priority of anything, because they just have waves of these pops. Like, I'm looking at pops from the convention from this time last year that they said I have on the shelf, one that nobody cared about. So I don't know, just a little bit of a tip for you guys. Anyway, I gotta rush. I have like 20 minutes to actually be on the floor of my job, so I'm gonna go rush in here real quick, get these pops, and head to work. Okay guys, so like I predicted, they had tons of everything. I got what I was looking for, and I have like 5 minutes before I have to get to work, but it's all good. I'm super close, I'm gonna make it on time. And yeah, that's the start of my day. But there should be another couple of pops that I add onto my collection, but we will see. Okay guys, so quick update, I was actually able to secure some of the pops from the Funko website, so you guys are gonna be seeing them in a future video. And I gotta really commend Funko for actually having all the shared pops on one website. So it made it really convenient for, say, you couldn't get to a certain store, that certain store wasn't in your area that had a pop that you were looking for, you can actually just go on the website. It wasn't a guaranteed lock that you would get the pop that you were looking for, but at least it gave you a chance, which usually that's all you can ask for. So that was pretty cool. So I was able to get a few off of that website. And I just got off work, and when I went to my local GameStop, they only actually had one of the pops that I was actually interested in buying, but I had already gotten it off the website. So kind of took an L on that one, but it's all good. I mean, it happens. So anyway, so kind of due to unforeseen circumstances, and this is the only time I will ever mention this virus that happens to share the same name as a particular Mexican beer, my job is now closed for the time being, which sucks and everything. But thankfully I do have another job, so I will be able to make some income and support myself and everything. So I don't, first of all, I don't want you to have to like feel any pity for me. Like, I will be okay. There are people in way worse circumstances, so I will strive and things will work out. But anyway, getting back to the positivity. So actually now we're headed to another GameStop to get one of the other pops I was interested in, and it'll probably be the last one I pick up. I mean, there were a couple other ones I thought were kind of cool, but I don't need them at the end of the day. It's just kind of something that I like, but I don't need. I might end up hitting up the FY, my local mall, but I don't know. It's like, after what happened, it kind of makes you look at things in perspective and everything. But it's going to be kind of one of those things that, do I need it? No. Do I like it? Sure. But we'll see. Okay, guys. So I was able to secure the pop I was looking for, as you guys can see. And I'm going to show you guys all my pickups from earlier today once I get back to the house. Okay, guys. So this is actually the day after the convention. I got a majority of the pops that I was looking for, but there was just one pop that I just could not seem to obtain. But I got some free time due to unfortunate circumstances, so I'm going to try my luck at my local Target and see if I can pick up this particular pop that was shared with them in the Funko convention or whatever. So we're going to go head over there right now and see if I can obtain it. Okay, guys, so what felt like an eternity, but in real time it was probably like 3 minutes. I'm finally here at the Target, about to park my car and then head into the store. And for those that are wondering that saw my last video, no, I have not tried to hit on my friend slash the worker at Hot Topic, but I'm definitely still thinking about it. It will happen at some point. You're good. Okay, guys, moment of truth. And unfortunately, it's not looking good because I definitely don't see what I'm looking for. But it is what it is. We tried. What the hell is that? The damn dark crystal pop up there? Whatever. Okay, guys, so we're into another Target now. I checked the website. It said they had the pop that I was looking for, but that's never a guarantee because literally the pop could be on a random ass shelf somewhere and it would still say it's in stock just because it's still in the store. Pro tip. But anyway, we're gonna go head out there and see if we can find it. Okay, guys, so we're at Target number two. Hopefully it yields a better result, but you never know. About to go head in, got my game face on, and hopefully we secure the pickup. You know what? I really want the pop, but if they had Stranger Things season 3, I would also consider that a win, because that was definitely something I was hyped about, but have yet to see any of the episodes. So hopefully they have the pop I want and season 3 of Stranger Things. Like, that'd be a double win. Okay, guys, so the mission was a success. I was able to secure the pop. Huge shout outs to the guy that helped me out in the customer service. I take back every negative thing I've said about Target. They came through today. It was in the back. I got the pop I was looking for, so I am a happy camper. About to head home and show you guys all my pickups from the last 2 days. Okay, guys, so I'm back home. I'm going to show you guys all my pickups from the last 2 days. This is actually going to be part one of a two-part reveal because I'm actually currently waiting on my pickups from the Funko website. So look forward to that in a future video. But I'm going to show you guys all the pickups from the stores I went to, and I gotta say, overall, the experience was pretty chill for the most part. It didn't have the same convention feel because of current world situations, and yeah, so it kind of took a little bit of the fun of having to wait in the line and getting to know people and just hoping that you got the pop that you were anticipating buying. But it is what it is. I was able to get all the pops that I was interested in, so I can't complain. It just didn't have that same feel, but hopefully by the time they have the next convention, things will be worked out and life can go back to normal. But anyways, I'm gonna get right into it and show you guys all my pickups in no particular order. Okay, guys, so kicking things off, we have my last pickup of the convention that comes courtesy of Target. Of course, it is Dr. Doom, my favorite Marvel supervillain. Had to have this one. As you guys can see, he is in his God Emperor attire, which is super sick. Glad I got this one. Like, this is definitely on the top of my list of pops that I had to pick up once I saw the reveals and everything. Kind of weird, however, the fact that it's the Emerald City Convention, and typically their thing is they're all about green, and his traditional costume is green, so the fact they switched it up was kind of interesting, but I think it's a dope pop nonetheless, so I'm glad I picked it up. Next up, we have my pickup from FYE, and I gotta say, I was very on the fence about this particular pop. I know there's one every convention, and this was definitely that one for me because of the fact that I really, once I saw it, deliberated on do I need this pop? I went through the pros and cons in my head. So much, in fact, I actually had left the store, did some errands, and came back like a couple hours later and decided that, yeah, I do need this pop in my collection. And I only had two bops. And the other one that I originally went in to go pick up, I actually ended up leaving in favor of this one because there was way less of it. And I kind of felt like if I didn't get it, I'd regret it. And of course, I am talking about the Triclops. Dope looking pop, but it definitely wasn't one that I was going to go rushing to go get that day. Like, I don't know. I just think it's an okay pop. And I feel like down the road, I'm going to be like really happy that I did get it at the time, but I don't know, just kind of one of those borderline pop that you just pick up and you go, you know what? Did I need it? Maybe I didn't. Who knows? But I'm glad I have it in my collection nonetheless. I think the Master of the Universe pops are super dope. I do have the Buzz Off and a couple of other pops that you guys are gonna be seeing in future videos. But yeah, it's here and couldn't be happier. Next up, we have my pickup from GameStop, and it was probably the pop that I was the most excited about picking up that day, and it is the Galantis Cube from Dungeons and Dragons. I'm not gonna lie, I am not familiar with that game at all, but I thought this was a sick looking pop nonetheless. Like, I saw it in glance and I was so curious on how it would turn out in real life, and I am not disappointed by any means. Surprisingly, it's like kind of heavy, and it's not actually the traditional pop standard box and everything, so I don't know how we'll fit this in a pop protector, but regardless, I'm gonna do my best to protect this box because it is such a dope pop and definitely one of the pops I was the most excited about picking up. Like I said, this might be, if not number one, then clearly number two. And I can actually see this being one of my top 10 pickups from 2020, even though it's super early in the year and there's tons of pops left to be picked up, but this is definitely one I'm super excited about, and I got really lucky on this one because the first GameStop I went to that day had actually sold out within an hour, but thankfully there are tons of GameStops in my area. So the second one I went to, I called, they had it, I picked it up, and as you guys can see, it's here, and I couldn't be any happier. So moving into my pickups from Hot Topic, it was actually the first store I stopped in that day, and primarily it was because of the fact that it was the only store open before I had to go to work. I knew they'd have plenty of pop, so it wasn't like a big priority to get there first, but kind of sort of worked itself out. They did have a pop that I was really interested in, so had to go in there primarily to get this one. It is, of course, Zatanna. The main reason I wanted this pop, because just looking at it brought joy to my heart. The same way that I just smiled on the inside when I saw the Sabrina pop from last year, like the comic book edition, it's kind of the same way I felt about this pop. Like, how can you get angry when you look at this pop? Like, just look at it. Like, she has a little top hat on, her little wand. Like, how can you be sad when you see this? Like, it's such a dope looking pop. And I love classic comic book characters in general. Like, I need to add some more to my collection. Like, I know I'm missing the Black Widow. And I don't know if I have the Nick Fury Classic Edition. I might, but I'm not sure. I'm getting to that point where I have so many pops, I'm just losing track. But this was definitely a no-brainer. As soon as I saw it in the glams, I was like, I'm getting this pop, and now it's here. Next up, we have Tonks from Harry Potter. I'm not gonna lie, I am not familiar with this character at all. I saw the first three Harry Potters and just tapped out. I know they'd make like 10 movies down the road and everything, and apparently I was the first person to pick up this particular pop, which is crazy because I ended up going to the store like 30 minutes after it opened. So I don't know, I just thought it was a cool looking pop. Like, I do have a couple of pops in the Harry Potter line, so my collection is getting a little bit better, but and I'm just not familiar with the character. I thought it looked cool. And last but not least, we have Perfect Cell from Dragon Ball Z. Like I said, I didn't really fear any of the pops selling out at Hot Topic because of how many I knew they were gonna get. But it's always the Dragon Ball Z pops that seem to go first. So especially something as cool as this that glows in the dark, it's hit or miss. Like, I don't guarantee anything, but it's usually a 90% chance that you can get the pop that you want from Hot Topic, unless it's like I said, something crazy like the Chrome Vegeta last year. that sold out. The Piranga, that sold out. Again, Dragon Ball Z Pops. Get them. Be in line early for them. But anything else, you can get pretty much whenever. But anyway, I'm glad I got this. I think it's a sick-looking pop, and I think it's super dope that it glows in the dark. Like, if it glows in the dark, I usually will buy it, especially Dragon Ball Z Pops. I haven't seen the show in forever, but I think they make some of the coolest pops, so I tend to buy them every convention, and yeah, here's another one to the collection. Okay, We Want Funko family, that's going to do it for this video, but let me know in the comment section below what was your guys' favorite pickup from this year's convention. Let me know what you guys were able to pick up, and yeah, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me and checking out this video. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you guys hit that like button. You definitely share it with a friend. If you feel the vibe, hit subscribe. You guys can follow me on Twitter and on Instagram at WeWantFunko. And until the next video, remember, party on. Peace.